Hey guys, Man of Steel 00 from Maple Syrup Gaming. We're going for another Vi Jungle match. This is a match I recorded and I'm going to basically play back and comment for you guys. So, as normal, if you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up down below. If you didn't, a thumbs down. And if you leave a thumbs down and you want to let me know what I could do better, hey, go ahead. And if you want to leave any other comments, questions, whatever, feel free to as well. So, basically, you know, for people who are watching the first video, right now I'm maining Vi in the jungle because she is, in my opinion, the strongest jungler right now for all situations. And so for someone looking to climb, looking to main a solid all-around jungler, Vi, in my opinion, is the right choice. So we're starting off on the blue side, which is my preferred side anyway, because with Vi, starting off blue side means you can spam out your abilities without having to worry at all about your mana. And it's the easiest side to gank from if you want to go in for an early level 3 gank. Now, once you clear the wolves, I always like to go for River Crab. Not only that, but it gives you an idea if the other jungler is going to be aggressive or not. And here, unfortunately, the other team actually got first blood. So, ganking bot is going to be out of the question for the moment, because you don't want to go in 1v2. So as soon as you see one of your laners die, best idea is just to hang back, keep an eye on the situation, and here I get into it with Warwick. Katrina, however, was coming to step in, so we're going to pull it back. Nope, I see a play here with Ziggs, but level 3, it's not worth it. Because if Katrina pulled back to her tower, basically you know you can't dive, you can't follow. Now I see both my laners back on the bottom, and I decide to see if there's something we can do to basically, you know, make up for the basic first blood. That flash was actually pretty bad on my part. Let's just pretend that never happened. No. You know, can never do it perfect, but basically I overshot the misfortune, which I wasn't expecting. So my mouse was sort of ready to click, but in the wrong direction. So I see here that there's not much we can do, and we're not going to waste any more time and steal XP from our laners. So we're going to keep going on in the jungle, and we're going to go look for clearing top now. By the way, I'm going to try to get some, once the Warwick rework comes out, I'm going to try to get some Warwick videos out for you guys. Let me know if anyone's interested in seeing any of those, because it is a champ that, it's the first champ I ever played in League of Legends. However, since he's, for the moment, in my opinion, totally uncompetitive in anything but early bronze levels, well, unfortunately I haven't been playing him for quite a while. So I'm actually looking forward to a Warwick rework to maybe bring him more relevant. So once again, if you guys are interested, leave comments down below, and I'll try to make it happen. If you want to see any other junglers that you're interested in, let me know as well. I'd normally play junglers who can abuse Courage of the Colossus because I like the mix of damage and tankiness. So. Just to let you know, generally I can play pretty much any of those. So we finished clearing top. So far it's been pretty uneventful. Mid lane is missing from the map, and we can see top lane Poppy's pushing the Nasus back. So fortunately, once again, we're a little bit too low to be able to gank where they can run under tower. So I'm just going to get my Poppy some vision top, so that if the jungler pops out through the river, she's going to see him coming from far. Check quick on blue. Always a good idea to see if your opponent's buffs are up, because you never know. They could have taken an odd path, gone off track and left a buff up. I see Nasus here getting walled, so I get a good opportunity to go in. Unfortunately, once again, we can't make it happen because diving at this low level is not a good idea. Worst comes to the best scenario, there would have probably been going one for one, me killing the Nasus and then dying to tower. And I don't want to feed the Nasus a kill, even though I really would have liked to get a first kill. I see the Nasus pushing back slightly, but so we're going to go back. Now, on Vi, right now, I recommend skipping your jungle item to begin with and rushing right away at Trinity Force. The basically, the gameplay is better. The overall damage that you get from the proc on Trinity Force is way above what you get from your jungle item. The 20% cooldown reduction is great with your ultimate. So, right now, I recommend I usually skip the jungle item, grab a pair of boots, and start working on Trinity Force. So here we're going to clear bot. Now I'm trying to rush to level 6 so that I can actually have my ultimate for a really potent gank. Top of it, Warwick got a kill, so what we want to do? Oddly enough, I'm playing against a Warwick this game. Now I see my bot lane being pushed in pretty hard, so instead of doing my Gromp, I decide to go take a look and see what we can do there. However, seeing as how low Jinx is, there's not a big play we can do there. I'm better off just once again rushing so I can get my level 6 and have my ultimate up. And there we get it. So now we're actually going to see if we can start turning the tide of this game so far. Because with a score of 2-0 to start with, it's not the best start we could have hoped for. So I'm actually going to circle around, try and see if we can't box them in. And I see that the Morgana is pretty much left to on her own. So we're going to focus down the Morgana. Ult in. It's a 1-for-1. I'm just hoping my laners can maybe clean up the misfortune. Unfortunately, it doesn't play out that way. And here I start working on my second component of the Trinity Force. So I grab a Ruby Stone and a Longsword. I usually go for, generally if I can, I go the mana item, then I go the damage, and I end with the attack speed portion of it. Just because ultimately on Vi you're better off having a strong Q and a strong follow-up auto attack than necessarily going in for long trades and then, you know, the attack speed. Because especially early in the game, you're going to be ganking a lot under tower, so you can't be standing there trading with attack speed. Once again, it's a pretty quiet game, but now at least we've evened up the score. So, and here I see Warwick coming top to gank Poppy, but once I see him turn around, I know there's no reason to stick there, and instead we're going to try and see if we can't get the mid laner here. So far the ganks this game have been tough. We've been missing it by very, very little. Charge my Q there, scare off the mid laner, and we start working on the tower to push it down. There we go. So we got first blood on tower. We got the extra gold for the whole team. It's always a positive thing if you can get first tower blood. It's something that honestly in solo queue people underestimate, especially in the lower tiers. But it's so important because it not only puts you ahead, but it helps your team as well. An early kill, unless you can feed a couple of assists, will help one of you. And you see there, I saw Nasus dropping a ward, so there was no good going in. He would have seen me coming a mile away. So we're going to go around, we're going to try and get a little bit more farm. Oh, and I see Nasus trying to work on steal my top farm. But there's no use chasing, especially without vision of the top lane. For all I know, Warwick could have been in the bush, right on near the top lane. And that's why Nasus was pushing, and actually he was. So, there's no use going in for a free trade, giving them a free kill like that. So then we're going to pop vision, and yes, they're still there. I ping my top laner, tell her, you know, Warwick and Nasus are there, let's see what we can do. And Warwick, at this point, I sort of realized in mid-trade that he must be AFK or DC, because if you saw, he just stood there, did absolutely nothing while we destroyed him. So at this point, I actually realize the Warwick has probably DC'd, so I'm going to keep an eye out. If we don't see him pop up anywhere on the map anytime soon, it gives us a good idea that we've got a great advantage for this game. So now, as you saw, we got our attack speed item, so our Trinity Force is almost finished. Next back, we're going to have it for sure. So I'm going to go grab the blue buff here if I can. Actually, yeah, we start pinging Dragon because I see that we have boat control. Bot lane isn't there, mid lane isn't there, so it's the perfect time, and plus it's an Earth Dragon, so objective contributes to basically getting the objectives faster. Fortunately, my bot lane is very slow to respond. I have only got Sona coming, but it's enough at this point because anyway, I could have taken Dragon alone. Just a question that we could have gotten it much quicker, giving me time to actually get my blue buff. In this case, oh. Fortune knows we're there, so we're just going to stick around, and no good, so we're going to move mid. I see Katrina going hard on the Ziggs, so it maybe gives us a perfect opportunity to gank the Katrina here, because it's rare that you'll get out of a trade with Ziggs at full health. And there, I see Katrina. And we're going to finish up with a Q auto, and there you see the damage you get from the auto after a Q, thanks to Trinity Force, is excellent. It gives you an excellent combo of basically Q, auto, E, and then if you really need it and you have your ultimate up, you can ultimate, and by that time your Q will almost be up again. So bot lane's still having a little bit of hook trouble. Morgana unfortunately saw me coming and cues me right there. And I arrived just in time to see Jinx dying. So then I decide to get vision before we go in because I'm out of wards for the moment. Unfortunately, I get queued again by the Morgana. You see that the Morgana's queues this match are extremely well timed. And unfortunately, we set them ahead there. So it was really one of the weaker plays I've made this match. So unfortunately, we will hope that we're going to be able to pull it back. I'm leaving. Well, if you guys saw the title of the video, the surprise is sort of ruined as to how this game goes, but you know, still, we'll keep the surprise a bit. You won't know if we actually won or not. So we're all back up, and now I see my team all moving into mid lane, so we're gonna go see if we can't pressure and sort of start working our way down to mid lane, try to work on the tier 2 tower. Top lane has been pretty quiet. Poppy's been holding her own against Nasus, but unfortunately at that point I see the Katrina coming in, so I decide to grab my red buff just really quick before I go help. For that extra burn, the extra damage. Especially against the Katrina, you want to be able to burst her quicker than she can burst you. Fortunately, Katrina manages to slip through our fingers, so I decide to basically ward the bush. I see Nasus staying there, and basically we're going to try and box him in between me and Poppy. I Q, auto E, ultimate, and we have him down. Now the ultimate's really important there, just because, especially with Nasus, you can't trust Poppy to follow up. She doesn't really have any really good gap closers other than her E, and on top of it, her E will push Nasus further away from you. And secondly, again, that Morgana Q is just horrendous this game. You're gonna see over and over again that Morgana was landing each and every Q she threw my way this game. And always in one of those bottlenecks where no matter what happens, you can't really dodge it. I don't know if you can feel the frustration in my voice, but I still remember how peeved I was every time saying, oh my god, she landed her Q again. And her Qs are just, Morgana's Qs are just so long. So I unfortunately grabbed the wrong boots this game. So I grabbed basically the boots that lower slow times. I should have grabbed the boots that lower freezes so that Morgana's Qs were less potent. But, you know, ultimately I was just more worried in the early game about Misfortune's slows than I was about Morgana's Qs, which is why I grabbed those boots. But anyway, so now we start working on our jungle item. Once we have our Trinity Force and our level 2 boots, and we grab blue buff, lowers your cooldown, and gives by mana regen so that you can really spam out your E's every time it comes up. And now with 30, you know, we're working toward 30% cooldown reduction. It's actually an important difference. So I see here my team sort of looking for a play on Katrina. So we're gonna go help them out and see if we can't just get a quick pick on them. Morgana's there as well, so I'm gonna ult her and shut her down. So that time, she didn't land her Q. Not that I would have saved her anyway, but it just felt good to get a kill on her. I see Katrina unfortunately take Ziggs out. I return and take out the Katrina. And we see more Misfortune top, seeming to want to make a play with Nasus on our Poppy. So we're going to go and see if we can't muddle their plans up a bit. So obviously I want to go for Misfortune first. Take her out of the equation. She gets out of range, so I go hit the Nasus, come back, switch, dodge Misfortune's ult as much as I can, and unfortunately they get away and they get a kill on us. So not the best play, but at that point the Misfortune comes back and we take her out. But it cost me my life, unfortunately. My team continues on the fight, and they get Jinx. And they get the Poppy as well. So unfortunately, still, this game is still going hard, but this is actually an example of a game where Noma, even if you're losing, it's not, never a bad, don't give up hope. I mean, yes, we're losing, yes, we're doing really bad trades, but ultimately, I mean, this game is still winnable. So, you know, the important thing is keep a mind on tightening your gameplay as much as possible. Try to make less mistakes. And, you know, I got tilted a bit this game. As you can see, I'm sort of going very often for the Morgana. But, you know, you try to bring it back. You try to remember that, look, who cares how many times she killed you? Because in the end, you'll have the last laugh if you win. So, here we're going to clear the jungle a little bit. I see the Katrina there, but once again, I want my red buff. And what I definitely want is I don't want Nasus stealing my buffs, because Nasus with red buff is just ridiculous. Here, Katrina, we ult her. And we're going to Q to finish it up. So unfortunately, Misfortune is working on our bot turret. Now I'm going for Nasus here nonetheless, just because time it would have taken me to go bot map, and with the rest of my team going top, I wanted to be there, make sure that we had as good of a return as we could. Nasus thinks he's getting away. The slow, we Q him, and we get an extra kill on him. So now I cleared it top really quick, and I start backing right away so that we can go and help bot lane with Misfortune. Anyway, my team are 3 to push down the top tower. They don't need me, and I don't trust that the Ziggs will be able to 1v1 the Misfortune. At the same time, once I get there, I see that the Misfortune has actually backed. We're gonna take the farm, and we fall upon her. So let's see if we can't chase her down. At this point anyway, I'm not too scared, because I know that most of the other players on the map died top lane. And I also know that I can put the Misfortune down pretty quick. So when my ult came up, I ulted her right away and we took her out. So there, you saw. We are going to red smite him, give us that juicy burn, and Ziggs ults him down. So now we're starting. This is sort of the point where the game starts to get back in hand for us. So we made an excellent trade bot lane. We got 2 kills. We pushed the lane to mid, and I get to farm out the jungle. At this point, I see that we got a dragon, so what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna come here and see if we can't grab the dragon before. So I go in. However, I see that there is unfortunately a ward, so I decide to turn around and get back. At this point, the Warwick reconnects, so we've actually been fighting 5v4. This whole time, if you guys haven't noticed, I already knew, and I actually didn't tell my team, because sometimes when you tell your team that you're 5v4, they start making even worse plays, thinking that there's no way we can lose. However, if you saw this game, we've been 5v4, and basically we've been having a hard time. So at this point, my team wants to forfeit, so I actually tell them, dude, we've been 5v4. This game is winnable. Let's just pull it together and take them out. So I ult the Morgana ult instantly. Once again, a little bit of tilt there, but you know, should have kept it for basically probably the Katrina right there. Could have maybe saved my Ziggs, but you know, at least we secured the kill on Morgana. So we're going to start pushing down mid lane. Nasus was pressuring top, but with all of us coming mid, you know, we didn't even have to worry about him going top, because we know he's going to recall. He can't let us just free reign all 4 of us in mid lane like that. And then Nasus actually shows up. Poppy walls him. Start working on him. He's too tanky, so we just switch it to getting the inhibitor down. And we got another kill on Nasus. However, that that ult, that misfortune ult, was just excellent. So unfortunately, she almost wiped out our whole team in one ult. So the game is still going as it's been since the beginning. We make good plays, but then they make better ones. At this point, at least, if you start looking at my items, we're able to start going tanky. So basically, you know, I have my Deadman's Plate finished, and I start working on Spirit Visage. Now, the reason I choose Spirit Visage is because I usually go for a Lifesteal item last, and the Spirit Visage plus Lifesteal is excellent. So right here, I start going to the top jungle, see if I can get any extra farm, because we really need to catch up. We have to keep farming hard so that we can compete with them, knowing we have less kills. However, I'm the most fed on my team by far, so I know that I have to stay close for team fights, and that's an important thing, is when you have this such a disproportionate amount of kills to your team, you can't be far from any possible team fight because they'll just get smashed. However, on their team as well, the Misfortune has the lion's share of kills, so when we can pick Misfortune off the map, the rest, I know that we can handle the rest after that. Nasus comes, but unfortunately we can't catch him. So we're just going to work on pushing the tower down, but our wave is at the other end of the map, so there's not much we can do here. See, I hadn't noticed because I came and joined my team, but they actually moved down the map without pushing the lane, which is sort of useless. However, at the same time, Poppy's taking the top tower, so at least you can, you know, we're moving down the map quickly, so I'm going to go help the Poppy. However, on the way, once again, some juicy farm. We can do that pretty quick. Why not? Now I have double buffs here, red and blue. I see the more Misfortune under tower, so it's not worth going in, especially probably because she has her ult up. So my team here are starting to work on Baron, which is probably the right call right now, because they all seem to be turtling in base. And with all of us here, we can get this down pretty quick. There we go. So we're going to port back to base. I'm going to try and finish my item here. So we're going to grab Spirit Visage. And now, next stop will be some a Lifesteal item. So in a case like this, we have, you know, we're gonna see where I go, but normally we're always debating between, you know, the Lifesteal Hydra or going basically probably, you know, any other item that gives you at least 10 to 20% of Lifesteal. So you could go basically. Sorry, just a second, sorry guys, I just want to make sure because the play I really want you guys to see for this match is coming up soon and I just don't want to miss it. So yeah, you can go any Lifesteal item basically, you know, with Vi. The important thing is to sort of match the situation if you want more tankiness, more movement speed, or basically if you just want to go pure damage. On this point though, I would normally say I rarely go pure damage just because on Vi you're better off, you know, you have enough damage as you can see, you can bring down someone pretty quick. You're better off going for tankiness, especially with a team composition like this one where Poppy is the only real tank we have. So although they're ahead on kills, on objectives we're doing very well. So we're going to push down the bottom inhibitor here and we're going to right away start working towards the mid inhibitor. There we go, so we have two lanes down. Now I call for a back because there's no reason to start pushing here, to keep pushing here. So I call just to go back. We have Baron, we have everything. Let's go grab the dragon. So I call for a dragon here because basically it's another Earth dragon. It's going to help us on the last two towers. So there's no reason to let this slip through our fingers. And this is a match where we need all the advantages we can, because honestly, even though right now we're in a good position, one really bad team fight and this could all slip away really easily. So we back, we have all our lanes pushing in, so that's always good. And we have Misfortune and clearing in mid, so we know she's not roaming the map. And we have this Katrina alone trying to pick elements of our team off with the Warwick. However, we picked the Katrina. Honestly, I have no idea why she's going off like that on her own, because at this point in the game, did you really think she's going to be able to go through our jungle and get a pick off on one person on her own? It was highly doubtful, so that was a misplay in my opinion on her part, but you know, never know. Maybe she was hoping to pick off our Jinx or our Sona. Because other than that, she can't really zero, she can't 100 to zero anyone else on our team. Like, she's not going to 100 to zero Poppy, she's not going to 100 to zero me. Maybe Ziggs, actually. Maybe she can maybe get the Ziggs as well. Once again, that Misfortune ult is disastrous. Devastating. She gets the kill here on me. So at this point I know that unfortunately if my team doesn't pull out, we're going to wind up in a bad position, so I start calling them all back. Like, leave the Poppy, just get out of there. However, the one thing is that they've left their towers undefended, so our minions are working on their final base towers. So we're in a pretty good position now still, even though unfortunately, they got a couple of good kills on us. We were a little bit too aggressive there, going for the tower. We should have just pulled back and worked on the other two lanes, but, you know, sometimes you try too hard. So as you see here, I bought the first portion of a lifesteal item. Especially when you have the Spirit Visage, you want to go right away for the lifesteal portion of it, so that you can actually profit from the extra healing. So here my team calls for a group mid. We're waiting for Poppy. And this is going to be the play I've been waiting for a long time on Vi and Ranked. So here we call for a push mid. We decide to grab all the farm we can. And we start pushing our way down. However, they clear. And we still don't have Sona and Poppy, so we pull back temporarily just to reposition. So we managed to get the Warwick that overextends. We also managed to get Misfortune down, however, at this point I realize it's not going to be a winning situation, so we decide to pull back. There's me and Ziggs left on the map, and I see a problem coming from top lane. Once again, I'm just gonna probably try and grab the blue buff here before going back. And we're gonna go recall, try to reposition with the team, and try to maybe make another push. So unfortunately at this point, both their inhibitors are back up, and it's the same situation as we had earlier. They're still ahead on kills, and all they need is one, you know, basically the first team that aces the other is gonna probably win this game. We have a little bit more of a buffer because we still have our inhibitor towers up, but other than that, I mean, at this point in the game, an inhibitor tower can be down in seconds, especially if their lanes are pushing. So right now, what's important is that we keep every which one of our lanes pushing. So both bot and mid, we have them pushing. And we're going to start working towards going for... we have bot and top pushing, so what we're going to do is we're actually going to go down straight mid. So I call to group mid and decide to grab all the juicy farm that's there because we had a huge wave coming. However, I see my team engaging without me, which isn't a good idea, but we're going to do what we can to turn it around. So right here we have Poppy with an awesome ult. We get the first two people down. I see Katrina. Get Katrina down. Triple kill. We go for the Nasus. Just because he's the bigger of the two threats, especially because the Warwick's been AFK. Quadra kill. And the Pentakill. Been waiting for a long time for a Pentakill on Vi in ranked. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this, because this is our final push to the end of the game. It was a spicy one, could have gone either way the whole time, but it's an example of why you shouldn't lose hope and keep pushing, because basically, with a few good plays, playing the objectives rather than the kills, we managed to finish this game. And we get an extra kill on the Morgana. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, leave your comments below. Thumbs up if you liked it, thumbs down if you didn't. And if you didn't, let me know what I can do better. And like I said, if any of you guys want to see a Warwick video or any other, you know, junglers, just let me know in the comments and I'll do my best to be able to get you some good, fun videos. Have a great day.